Hey everyone, this is David Brown from Lyco Birds. In this video, I will explain how to identify turkey vultures and black vultures, which are the two vulture species in the eastern United States. First, let's look at a soaring turkey vulture. The head is small and red because it isn't covered with feathers. Look at the overall pattern of light versus dark on this bird. The body and underwing coverts are dark, but the actual flight feathers of the wings and tail are silver. Also note that the tail is relatively long. Now, let's look at a turkey vulture in a glide. This bird is lit up from underneath by the sun reflecting off of a layer of snow. Again, we see how small the head is, especially if we were to compare it to a bald eagle, for example. We see the same contrast between the brown feathers of the body and coverts, and the silver flight feathers. The tail is long and rounded when closed. Here is a turkey vulture coming toward the observer. Notice how the wings are held in a V shape known as a dihedral. The stronger the wind, the more pronounced this V becomes. Turkey vultures are very unsteady and teeter or wobble when they fly, especially in strong winds. If you see a large, dark bird holding its wings in a steep V and teetering, you can be sure that you are looking at a turkey vulture. Juvenile turkey vultures have gray heads and their feathers are all the same age. This gives them a clean appearance. Look for these fresh juveniles in late summer and during fall migration. Compare this to the adult turkey vulture at the bottom left, which is molting, or replacing, wing feathers, giving the trailing edge of the wings a jagged appearance. Turkey vultures fly in groups called kettles. They soar on a thermal to gain altitude, then glide to gain distance. Even from far away, we can tell that they are large, dark, teetering, V-shaped birds. When a turkey vulture is going away, sometimes the head and neck look larger. In poor lighting, you might mistake this for the head of an eagle. So be careful. One fun part of hawkwatching is finding interesting birds. The turkey vulture on the left is completely missing its tail, making it look like a flying wing. I have seen this a few times and it is impressive how well they are still able to fly. I photographed the turkey vulture on the right this spring at the Braddock Bay Hawkwatch in New York. This bird has some sort of pigment issue, making it much whiter than a normal vulture, especially on the top side, which you see in the corner photo. Now, let's take a look at a black vulture. In this close photo, we can see that the head is gray. The wings are short, giving the black vulture a compact shape. Let's focus on the pattern of dark versus light. The whole bird is dark other than the feathers that make up the wingtips. The tail is short and dark. A black vulture's toes sometimes extend beyond the tail. In the left photo, we see two black vultures. The left one is holding its wings in a shallow V that flattens out, sometimes called a modified dihedral. The vulture on the right is holding its wings flat. These are typical postures for black vultures compared to the steeper dihedral of turkey vultures. In the right photo, we see the field marks we learned on the previous slide. Short tail, white wingtips, and a compact shape. Now let's compare a turkey vulture and a black vulture side by side. The turkey vulture has a red head, whereas the black vulture has a gray head. The turkey vulture has more silver in the wings and tail. The black vulture has dark feathers except for the wingtips. The turkey vulture has a long, silver tail, and the black vulture has a short, black tail. Let's compare the two vultures head-on. Turkey vultures have a steeper V on average, especially in strong winds, although in these photos there is not much difference. Even from this angle, we can see the difference in the tail shapes. We can also see the difference in the head colors and the color of the wings, though this is dependent on distance and lighting. When gliding high overhead, the two species have different shapes. Turkey vultures are lanky with long wings and tails. Black vultures are compact with short wings and tails, and the white wingtips are obvious. When perched or on the ground, we notice that turkey vultures are quite brown, whereas black vultures are black. We can also still see the difference in the head colors and tail lengths. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe for more educational birding content. You can also visit our website at lycobirds.com. This is David Brown. Thanks for watching.